Here we uncover the man behind the controversial plays, such as the White Devil, the Duchess of Malfi, and a man who probably had creative input into many Shakespearean works. Before we delve into the man's life, it's important to get a sense of the context and society that he lived in.
Theatre was an integral part of British society and formed their main source of entertainment amongst all people. Plays were often performed outside and roles would often be crossed with different genders. Webster argued in the preface the optimum condition as how to perform the White Devil.
England was a deeply divided society during Webster's life. Under Elizabeth, England was under a Protestant rule, but then when Mary, Queen of Scots, returned back to Scotland, there was an impending threat of Catholicism from up in the north. This scandal ultimately cost Mary her life. But Protestant plots were a normal part of British society, with many plots, such as the Babington, Throckmorton and Ridolfi plot, devised by Catholics to thwart Protestantism. There are similar themes of corruption and mistrust in The White Devil, with many characters backcrossing each other.
We're now going to play an interview that historians have recently uncovered. With new technology from science, we were able to Skype back to the 1600s with our acclaimed interviewer, Alfred Dalton.
Thank you, A.S. Johal. Your critical perceptions of the White Devil are very insightful and will go down history. First, let's welcome the man, John Webster. John, do you want to get off the phone?
I don't really want to do this.
Okay, right, so would you like to tell us about yourself and your life, or be forgotten? Because at the moment, no image of you survives.
Well, you're recording me now, you'll be fine, so clearly there is footage of me out there, isn't there?
Okay, fine. Well, they said you were extremely intellectual. Right, so critics absolutely panned your plays, The White Devil, and also panned the Duchess of Malfi as well. And they say you recycled the same stories and you borrowed really heavily from Shakespeare.
Well, people just didn't really understand what I was trying to say.
Perhaps your pathetic accent had a bit of a part to play.
Like, fuck off, you bastard. No, as I was trying to say before, I was rudely interrupted. Many of my plays were intellectual to the point where it's almost as if the proletariat of the day didn't really understand me. I mean, I feel that I was cheated. The White Devil was a masterpiece, and just because it came 1,000th from the Times peasant rankings doesn't mean anything. I hardly doubt that he even count that high themselves. So,
right, okay.
Says more about them than it does about me.
Any chance you could tell us about your involvement with Shakespeare's work? Historians say that you had a big part in it.
Well, I'm afraid a large part of that is classified. All I can tell you is that me and some mates would regularly kind of get together, go down the pub, and a lot of the stories that we told in that pub ended up as Shakespeare plays. That's all I can say on that. But
interesting.
Take from that what you want.
Interesting.
That's because I am Shakespeare, you fucking idiot. Do you really think that Shakespeare could do all that himself? Have you noticed the similarities between Cornelia and Cordelia? There's no way that a two-bit actor could ever do that.
Okay, alright. So, maybe you were high on opium when you wrote it, perhaps?
Perhaps, maybe, but not now.
Okay, well, it would appear new developments show John Webster is actually William Shakespeare. Looks like I have a critical viewpoint for you to analyse, Mr. Johal. Thank you for your time, Mr. Shakespeare. Back to you all in the studio.
We now have to corroborate this with our history department. Thank you for watching.